Hello guys, my name is Oscar. You're welcome once again to my YouTube channel. Today I've got a quick little tutorial for you. I'm going to be showing you how to use your After Effects templates in your Premiere Pro timeline. So I don't want to waste much of your time. Let's just dive right into it. So right here on my screen, you can see that I've got an After Effects template open. I downloaded this from mixkit.co. You can check them out. They've got some free dope templates. So I just want to use this to show you what I'm about to teach you. Basically, the scenario is you've got this template and you want to use this on a Premiere Pro timeline. Normally, you would make your edits to this, export it, and then take it into your Premiere Pro timeline. Bad side about that is it takes a lot of time. And then also, if you make any mistake, so let's say you misspell something, you have to come back into Adobe After Effects and make changes and then export it again. And that's just time wasting. I'm going to show you how you can work with this same template right in your Adobe Premiere Pro timeline. So without wasting much of your time, let us get right into this. So to get started, I'm going to make my changes. I've got a template open. What I'm going to do, I'll make my changes. So the text one layer here, I'm just going to put my name. I'll put my name there, Oscar Elauchin. And then the text two is for the Instagram. I'll just write my Instagram handle, which is directed by Oscar. So as simple as that, I've made my changes, but for the purpose of this, I'm going to add an extra R. So we're making a mistake on purpose here. I want to use this now in Adobe Premiere Pro. So what we're going to do, you're going to go to the top here. I've already got the tab open, but for you, if you've not got the tab open, you go to the top here and look for essential graphics. And once you have that selected, it's going to bring up this panel here. And as you can see, all these elements we've got here are the elements which can be edited in Adobe Premiere Pro. So you could add more if you wanted to, but this is all we need. We've got the text one, which has my name, the fonts, the style, the size, and down to the colors. And it's got the same for the text too. I think we're good to go. So we want this in our Adobe Premiere Pro timeline. So I'm going to give it a name. I've given it a name here, which is Oscar YouTube Branding. And so I'm going to click here. There's a button right here at the bottom right. I'll click Export Motion Graphics Template. So I click that. It forces me to save the composition first, and I'll click Save. And the destination, I'll leave it as Local Templates Folder, so Adobe Premiere Pro can pick it up automatically. I don't have to start importing anymore. I can add a keyword if I wanted, but it's not needed, so I'll just add Oscar just for the sake of it. And click OK. Verifying Adobe fonts. I don't have any Adobe fonts there, so I'm just going to cancel that. And that's about it. So let's get into Adobe Premiere Pro and see if that has worked. So we're in Adobe Premiere Pro, and as you can see, I've got a timeline open already. I was working on something else, so I'm just going to use this as an example. So pay no attention to what I'm working on. First thing you're going to do is look for the graphics panel, just like we did in After Effects. And once you have the graphics panel selected, look over to the right. On the right here, you're going to see lots of motion graphics templates, and some of them came built in with Adobe Premiere Pro, and some of them were created by me, and some were just downloaded by other creators. So just scroll up to the top and you should be able to see Oscar YouTube Branding. This is what we just created right there in Adobe After Effects. So I'm going to go ahead and start that. The star here, what it does is once you start it, it means you don't need to search for this anymore. So instead of me having to search for Oscar and seeing that there's loads of templates named Oscar, I could just click the star and it's going to show me all my star templates. But that's that for that. I'm going to take this and drag it onto my timeline. And I'll bring the playhead over it, and you can see this is what we just worked on in Adobe After Effects. Let me take you back to After Effects. You can see this is what we're working on, and this is us in Premiere Pro, and we've got that right here. So now, the good part about this, you can see that we have a double R, which is an intentional error. So normally, if you wanted to make changes to this, you would have to go back into After Effects and then make your changes, export it, and then come back into Premiere Pro. We don't need to do that now. Just go back to your right in Essential Graphics under the Edit tab and look for Text 2. There we are, Directed by Oscar. I just have to backspace on that R and we should be good. And I'll use my Command S to save the project. It's as simple as that. That brings us to the end of this quick tutorial. If you enjoyed this, please give me a thumbs up, like this video, leave a comment and share it with someone who you think might find some value in watching this. Thank you for watching this video and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.